Very good afternoon, respected sir, and to everyone present over here. Today, I am going to deliver a presentation over the topic Application of Design Thinking in Retail Industry. So these are the contents which I am going to cover in this presentation, that is Introduction to Retail, Introduction to Design Thinking, and Phases of Design Thinking along with its implementation in Design Thinking in Retail, Future Scope and Scope. So basically, what is retail? As its simplest definition, retail is the sale of goods and services with the intention to make a profit. Now, retail includes both like offline and online selling of goods and services. Now, what are the growth drivers for Indian retail industry? Indian retail industry basically drives with increase in income level. That is, if the income level of the consumer increases, it definitely have impact on the retail industry. Brand consciousness. As the people get conscious about the brands, they get to know about the brand, they stick to the particular brands. Availability of consumer credit. As the ease of consumer credit, people are getting the credit and they are more able to purchase goods and services. Increasing awareness. As people are getting aware about the products, they are willing to purchase it. And growth of shopping malls. As the shopping malls are growing day by day, people are getting used to purchasing product. Evolution of retail in India. Basically, I have concluded this in four basic points. That is, first is traditional retail. Traditional retail, that is pre-1990s. Economic liberalization, 1990s. Then rise of shopping mall, 2000. And modern retail format, that is 2000 to 2010. Starting with the traditional retail. This one. Traditional retail includes all those traditional form of retail services like goods and selling of goods and services, which includes weekly markets, kirana stores, street shops, hawkers and so on. Economic liberalization is the phase where India had economic liberalization and many large companies entered into the India, and like food hubs like McDonald's and Pizza Hut were introduced. After that, rise of shopping malls. In 2000, there was a large trend of shopping malls that has been introduced in India. Like, for example, there are many malls, DLF Mall, Ambience Mall and so on. Modern retail formats basically includes all those retail formats which we are seeing today. For example, e-commerce, that is a very famous thing. E-commerce, that is selling of goods and services through online mode. And it also includes outlets like Big Bazaar, Reliance Retail and so on. After that, introduction of design thinking. What is design thinking? So design thinking starts with a belief that everyone is a designer and design is everywhere. Basically, design thinking is a human-centric, iterative, solution-based, problem-solving framework. If I conclude these points, that is human-centric, iterative, solution-based, problem-solving framework, it will be concluded as first human-centric. That means we seek to understand the users. Iterative, it means that you will be able to reshape these approaches until an optimal solution is chosen. Then solution-based. Solution-based means design thinking provides you a very hands-on approach to problem-solving. And problem-solving framework or design thinking helps us to understand and challenge any assumption, thus reframe it to get the potential solutions. After that, phases of design thinking. So basically, the five stages of design thinking as per the Stanford Design School, D School, now known as Hasso-Plattner Institute of Design, constitute the phases as empathize, define, ideate, prototype and testing. Empathizing basically means to understand your users and their needs. Defining means to analyze and identify the issues that need to be solved. Ideating means creating and sharing ideas, even the serious one you can think of. Prototyping means to draw up the solution, and at last testing, just as it says, go forth and test your solutions out. Now, if I conclude these phases of design thinking in retail industry, for the basic implementation, I will take the example like this. First, empathizing, that is, it is basically knowing your customer, empathizing with their pain points. For example, it basically includes what are the issues burning issues that needs to be resolved as per user's perspective. Second, define. The next step is to define these issues. Whatever the issues we have collected in empathize stage, we need to define them as a problem statement. Like we can take the example as a garment shop owner, how might we enhance the customers in a store experience. The next step is to ideate. Now, as we have concluded a problem statement that I told earlier, then in the ideate phase, we can think of various innovative ideas and solutions that can be thought of in the ideate phase. Like we can work regarding ambience of the store, services, accessibility, and flexible options regarding our products and services. The next step is to prototype. With all the gathered information, we can prototype the idea. Like it could be providing a virtual display map of your store at the entrance so that people can have easy accessibility, and providing at-home styling services. So these, if we take example of these two things, it can work as a prototype for the given solution problem statement discussed earlier. After that, testing. So last step is to test your solutions out. You can have the measure of your solutions by taking feedbacks from the consumers. So what are the future scope of retail business? I would conclude this in few points. Like first is use of robots. Use of robots, as we have seen that at many places robots are being used. Like it can use to detect shelf, it can use to detect price tags and all in the retail market, in the retail business, and also in the food courts. After that, AR and VR shopping. AR and VR, that is augmented reality and virtual reality shopping. As we know that the new technology is coming, that is virtual reality, and we can try on clothes through smart mirrors. We can also link these smart mirrors with our social media so that we can click pictures and take suggestions from our friends and families. So this is the upcoming technology which we will see. And omni channel assistance basically means exploring, reserving both online and offline services. Like we can reserve products and services online, and then we can purchase or pick up the product or service through offline store. We can use actually both channels, offline and online, in this omni channel assistance. After that, sustainable and ethical retail. That is, sustainability must be there by the sustainability will be seen by the retailers, although it is there, but it will be seen more in the future. Retailers will be more ethical towards their business, and sustainability means they might be using more eco-friendly packagings and so on. Then hyper-local retail and last mile delivery. Hyper-local retail means delivering products and services at specific locations, like quick deliveries, and last mile delivery, drones could be used for delivery options in the future. Data analytics and personalization. At last, data analytics and personalization is being used now as well, but it will be used more in the future. Data-driven technologies will be more used by the retailers to know the preferences of the consumers, and personalization will be helped more.